Javi, number 12, Sally Crew, number 15, Pagdala, number 17, Mateo, number 19, Matalso, number 22, Amor.
Camiguin-Misamis, Oriental, first of all, perhaps introduce us and starting list natin. Watch first for CMORFA. There's number one, Reyes Rafael. Person number four, let's say, person number five, Lutas Lampal. Number seven, Kieta Ken. Number 10, Rubio Aguino. Number 11, Bob Josh. Number 13, Lada Pablo. Number 14, Cascada Chet. Number 20, Mendoza Anton. 23, D. Charlton. Number 24, Dela Cruz Cesar. For Visayas, starting with number 14, the Lamparas Beans Zang. Number 13, Sonia Esteban. Number 49, Vina Carlos Muriel. Number 54, Ebrada Sian Uichi. And number 10, Songalia Richard Jacob. Okay, coach, while waiting for the events to, what they call it, to transpire, we'll be watching it live here in Zamboanga City, Joaquin Memorial Enriquez Grandstand. And here is partner coach Joseph.
Yes, Coach, no, as we will be witnessing now the squad in black, which is yung CMORFA against itong the very dangerous, so yung Central Visayas. Coach, syempre andito ka since day one. Could you perhaps give us a, you know, yung mga viewers natin who just tuned in, o ngayon pa lang manonood ng mga games, kung ano ba naging playing history nitong dalawang na team na to since day one?
So, pareho silang no loss, pero mas maganda yung performance na naganap between the sa events ng laro ng Central Visayas, kasi halos minarder nila yung mga kalaban. And now, there goes the toss between Visayas and Camiguin.
So, So, first possession, nandiyan po sa mga Central Visayas. And of course, they have been really, really aggressive on their offense, on their previous games. So, sa mga viewers natin from Visayas, ha, maayong buntag sa inyong mga taga-Sugbo. And of course, our viewers, syempre sa mga CMORFA. Bisaya gyapon, maayong buntag gyapon. And syempre, sa mga viewers natin dito sa Zamboanga, of course, ang dami dyan nanonood. By the way, congratulations, Zamba Sulta, winning their game earlier against Golden Dabao with 5-0. And sa mga viewers natin from Luzon and Manila, magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. I hope we will have a very nice football match today. It is a fine, sunny weather dito sa Zamboanga. Early on, both team trying to attack early. And syempre, nakita natin ngayon yung squad in red trying to gain possession. And that Central Visayas Football Association. Central Visayas now with the ball. Trying to organize their offense. Etong si CMORFA sa unang tingin, parang yung mga tall blocks ng ano ah, ng New Zealand. The only difference is hindi sila naghaka. Anyway, Central Visayas would try to score. But the defense of CMORFA is there to fold that attack.
Ito nga, nasa position ng bola ngayon para sa Central Visayas. At, defense ngayon ng CMORFA. Ito, nasa gitna ang bola. Ang ganda ng depensa noon.
So guys, please share the stream, ha. Of course, we need to know na ipaabot natin sa lahat ng mga viewers natin all around the Philippines. Siyempre, alam naman natin yung Philippines is a basketball crazy nation. But we also need to promote yung football. As we have witnessed a couple of days ago na nag-champion yung ating women's team. And of course, sooner or later, with programs such as this, yung PFF Bismin league natin would someday produce na, you know, future ASCAL players and perhaps someday would represent the country in an international stage or perhaps in the World Cup gaya ng ginawa ng ating mga female counterparts. And of course, for us here local sa Zamboanga, we also hope na yung mga local players natin, grassroots program, na would continue on developing and continue on honing their craft. Kasi yung football kasi, it doesn't matter. May medyo hindi masyadong factor yung height eh. As long as you have the skills, the speed, the athleticism, laban lang. Alam nyo naman tayong Pilipinas eh. Kung sa basketball, puro puso tayo. Dito sa football, hindi naman puro puso. It takes skills, hard work, determination, speed, and agility. Okay, ball is out. Shout out po sa lahat ng ating 416 viewers. Thank you so much for tuning in. Pagpasensya nyo na yung kasama namin natin dito. Ha? Kami ni partner coach dito. As, on the spot kami dito. Just to give you play-by-play action. Siyempre, dito lang yan sa Zamboanga City at Joaquin Memorial Grandstand. As this is the first time yung siyudad de Zamboanga nag-host ng ganitong kalaking event. And we are very much honored to host this event, a national event. Earlier nga, andito yung yorme namin, si Mayor John Dalipe, to support all teams. And he promised and commented na we will hold more games here, more leagues. Kung nakita nyo itong field namin dito, napakaganda. Promise, kung nakapunta lang kayo dito. it is a artificial grass turf, no, na you know, pwede rain or shine, pwedeng-pwede dito. And we promise you, bisitahin niyo yung Zamboanga, sobrang peaceful dito. Sobrang fanatic sa sport yung mga tao dito. So, both teams still anil as medyo andun pa yata yung adjustment eh. Mukhang they are trying to size each other and try to settle their offense and perhaps draw the first blood. Ayan na, si CMORFA on the attack. Medyo may physical na play dun ah. Si CMORFA still with the ball, but the defense of Central Visayas is there and they are now on the attack. So both teams playing really, really good defense. So ball is out. Sabi ni Jason Garcia, sana kada major city may turf. So if I'm not mistaken, no, dito sa Zamboanga City, this is the first city na may artificial grass turf. Correct me if I'm wrong. Kahit Cebu yata, walang grass turf. Again, correct me if I'm wrong. No? So napakaganda. And I think most, if not all, ng mga players dito, it is their first time to play on a grass turf. No? Yung Rizal Memorial Coliseum natin, ano ba siya? Artificial din. Artificial. So, it is a very big factor na yung mga under 19 dito, nagkakaroon na experience to play on this kind of turf. Because on a bigger event, they will play in Rizal Memorial Coliseum. And hindi na sila magbabago. They won't adjust sa turf. Maybe wala na yung rason na baka madulas, mainit kung maaraw, hindi na maputikan, whether umulan. And experience such as this will benefit really the football clubs of Philippines, especially yung PFF. As kung nakita nyo lang kung gaano ka-organize yung PFF organizations dito. From the rules regarding kung sino makapasok sa turf, with their broadcasting coverage, yung mga game officials natin, mga men behind the scene are very much organized. Now, this goes to shows kung gaano nakalayo yung football dito sa Pilipinas. Yes, of course, we still need improvements. We are very far, far yet from other nation, kahit dito lang sa Southeast Asia. But we're going there. No, you know, kung mas matutukan lang talaga. Once again, as I mentioned earlier, alam natin yung ano, yung Philippines is talagang basketball-crazed nation. Kahit nga natatalo, nananalo yung Gilas, andyan pa rin yung mga sponsors, yung suporta, all out pa rin. Well, napaisip lang ako, what if kung same support yung matatanggap ng football natin? Same sponsorship, same exposure on international scale. No, let's go. Back to the ball game tayo, guys. Both teams still is yet to score. As a winner of this match will eventually be the champion. Well, as we know, both teams wala pa ring talo. No? Both teams are starting quiet. Medyo maingat sila eh on their offense. As both teams is focusing on their defense. So, Coach, what can you say so far sa ongoing match natin?
As you have said a while ago, partner Joseph, they are sizing up on both teams or still sizing up. Kaya medyo tantyado pa yung mga offense at depensa nila. Humigpit lang yung depensa, pero yung mga offense nila parang ano pa rin eh. Hindi nila focus yung kung sino ang mag-offense sa kanila. At the moment kasi parang decoy, napapansin ko parang decoy lang itong pwesto na ito. Baka mamaya sa kabilang scoring nila. As I told you na medyo they're just still sizing up. The ball parang wala pang masyadong threat sa mga ano. And now here's the threat. There it goes. At tingnan mo, maganda pa rin yung depensa. Good save yun. Good save yon sa panig ng Central Visayas. At ito na naman sila na dumidiskarte na naman sa gitna. Ayun, coach, may threat na naman sa kabila. Kaya nga, ang strategy ng mga ito, focus lang muna hanggang sa malito sila, nasa kabila pala yung ano. Kaya tina mo, kung yung pattern nila, puro dito lang muna. Ito namin sa kabila, dito lang. Biglang iikot yan sa kabila mamaya-maya. Ganon ang football. Unlike sa basketball kasi may mga pattern tayo kung sino mag-offense up. And anybody can shoot. Hindi natin makita yung number nila ko, so layo. There it goes. Same procedure, same pattern, same game plan. Yun.
Almost.
Masyado lang mataas. Score sana yung Central Visayas noon. Ito, medyo maganda yung mga depensa ng both teams eh. Sizing up to each his own. High tech na talaga ngayon ang mga kwan ng Sambuanga. Oh. This is my first time to watch an event like this. Being a soccer player before, this is my first time in Sambuanga City.
Big event.
A big event, national. Good save. Good D. Oh, ganda ng mga pasa. Eh. Ganda rin ng depensa. Visayas ball. Goes. Tikta. There's the threat. Hanggang threat lang talaga. Ball's out. Remaining. Running time is 13:30 with both teams with a nil score. Camiguin ball possession, intercepted by the Central Visayas. There it goes. So, oh, there it goes, the foul, there's the whistle. I don't know what card is that. Yellow card? Medyo mainit na yung panahon, no? Kayang-kaya ng mga bata, oh.
Big factor dyan, coach, kasi ano eh, medyo hindi masyadong mahangin.
Yun. So,
hindi. It might be one of the factor na medyo mas mabilis silang mapatingin.
Yun.
Yung tackle na yun.
hassle nila. Outplay mo talaga yung dapat i-outplay mo talaga yung opponent mo para makalusot ka.
Pero kamatawa ka mo kalong.
Buenos dias, ole, Sambuanga, Takikitara na grandstand. Sa mga kababayan nating nasa national provinces, we're here in Sambuanga. A match between Central Visayas and Camiguin, RFA. Ganda. Yeah. Ganda ng save ng goalkeeper. Muntik na, score na sana yun.
Possession will remain with CMORFA. Yes,
CMORFA.
They will try another attack to score the first goal for their team. Coach Weber will score the first goal dito. Malamang will win this match. Well, that's just my prediction.
Arang, no, well, ganun din, ganun din ang assessment ko dyan. Eh. Yeah. Kasi pag na-maintain mo yung depensa mo, pag naka-score ka na, lamang ka na yan.
Sabi ni Ivan Soronio, sana palaging ganito magkakaroon ng live stream ang PFF Under 19. So I'm sure, the plan of PFF to continue to give you quality broadcast.
Yeah.
Okay, ito naman, ganda ng broadcast natin. So bringing you live action all the way dito sa Sambuanga City for our PFF Under 19 this week. Right?
Yeah. Yeah. Hopefully, coach, sa tuloy-tuloy ito mga events na ito ng ganito. Kahit mga 3 times a year lang, okay na ito. At least may mga this is the first time eh. Tagal natin dito ng hindi nakaroon. Ayun ang threat. Hoy. Muntik na sana 'yun.
Second try of Central Visayas to score. Well, syempre magpatuloy sila ng ganitong attack eventually.
Baka maka-score sila. Ganon din, ang both sides, parang ganon din yung mga threat nila. Banda ng match na ito. Pareho kasing walang lows eh.
Kaliente kasi grass. Kaya artificial.
Ito naman yung Central Visayas.
Yan, mag-attack na naman ng Central Visayas ngayon.
Just
pasada,
no?
Yun.
Once again, the defense of CMORFA is there to foil that attack. Shout out sa Trento FC from Steven John Engel.
Yun. Ball is out. Medyo maganda yung mga pasa ng Central Visayas. Kaya lang maganda rin yung depensa ng Camiguin. Yun.
So early on, no? Parang balance lang talaga bot yung
maka-draw pa ito.
Defense and offense nila. So ano ba yung ano natin? Mamaya, we will ask our game officials. Ano ba yung standing if the game maging draw? Who will have?
Sampado ko na yung parang
yung draw. Hopefully, makausap ulit natin si Coach William. Ayun, oh, si Coach William.
Mamaya, baka dito si Coach William. Ayun, dyan, oh. Some updates, pero medyo busy pa siya.
Inaanap niya yung mga tao niya.
once again. Central Visayas, we have an opportunity to score here. Ball and avoid an early opportunity for Central Visayas to score.
Yeah. It's Central Visayas ball again. There goes the threat. There goes the attack. No. Ball is out.
But as the game progresses, no, mukhang mas aggressive yung Central Visayas on trying to attack. Yeah. They already have two attempts.
To my understanding kasi Coach Joseph, parang meron silang Philippine team na player na nandyan sa under-19.
Yeah.
Yung Central Visayas. Kaya medyo lamang sila sa in terms of player.
And experience,
and experience
of course.
Lamang sila konti pero nobody can tell na may maganda rin yung laro ng CMORFA. Pag nag-draw ito, coach, malamang na ang mag-champion ng Cebu.
An opportunity to goal!
Yes, sir! Nauna, ladies and gentlemen, nauna na lamang naka-score ang CMORFA.
Kakasabi ko lang, na may mga Philippine team dito sa
Philippine team, pero we can never tell na magandang laro ng CMORFA.
And with that goal, listen to the crowd roar dito sa grandstand. With the delight of the bench ng CMORFA.
Number 9, Jeep.
I'm sure yung mga taga Cagayan diha, taga Camiguin.
Mostly, to my understanding kasi Coach Joseph, karamihan ng player taga Cagayan de Oro yan.
So, Quieta scores.
Quieta. Hindi man siya starter dito. Si Quieta, hindi siya starter.
Starter ito lang.
Hindi highlights? Naka-highlight lang. Si A.S. de la Riva.
So, squad in red.
Nakauna yung Camiguin ngayon. So, malaking pressure ito sa Central Visayas. Dapat maka-score sila, makabawi man lang. Yun.
There's the attempt.
There's the threat, pero wala. Good D.
Mga taga-CDO daw, shout out sa inyo mga taga-CDO. I'm sure you are enjoying your first goal. Siyempre, marami din mga taga Gingoog City dyan sa team na yan. So, balanse sila.
Balanse sila kasi CMORFA. Misamis, Oriental, Misamis. May Misamis sila dyan. May Plaridel.
It's still early in the ball game. As, anything could still happen with this match.
Yeah, true.
Siyempre, very dangerous tong Central Visayas.
That's true. Two thing na very strong mga ito. Kaya lang, maganda rin ang laro kasi ng Camiguin. Yung CMORFA. Kasasabi ko pa nga lang, naka-score na kaagad.
Minsan nga lang umatake, goal pa.
Goal pa.
Kahit na naka-focus sila sa defense.
Goal, cool.
So there's a whistle.
There goes the whistle. It's a foul.
And a yellow card that's been
yellow.
Called.
Duty foul lang yun, yellow card. Huwag lang red.
Laging nandyan yung defense ng CMORFA.
depensa nila. Oh, yun.
Third attempt. Mm. Still unsuccessful for Central Visayas. One man down for CMORFA. Nakita natin, that's jersey number 34 or 24, Miss De La Cruz Cesar. Well, I hope everything is fine. Siyempre, ayaw nating may ma to seriously get hurt. Kasi yung mga batang to, may mga future pa eh. Bright future ahead.
19 years old, under. So, ang pinaka-oldest yan, 19.
I think he will be replaced. Let's wait sa announcement ng Game Barker. Of course, we'd like to thank Mayor John Dalipe for allowing us to host the event here. Of course, yung final say sa kanya pa rin. And we have opened windows of opportunities here sa Zamboanga to host many more events dito. So, this is just the beginning of so
hopefully, Coach many events. Joseph, sana every month, kahit every month lang, maganda lang, magandang kwento, masimula sa Zamboanga.
Yes, even if kahit mga local ano lang. Local events.
Local pero tuloy-tuloy.
So, correction lang natin, no? It's CMORFA RFA. So, Camiguin is just part of CMORFA rather.
Yeah. Is he the goaler, Coach Joseph? Is he the goaler who have an injury?
Hindi naman.
Hindi? Hindi ay yung goaler nila?
Hindi. So we have a little lull here as our medics dinala sa stretcher yung player ng CMORFA. As he seemed really hurt, hence naka-stretcher siya. Well, you know, it's part of the game, part of the sport na may nangyayaring such as this.
Take na physical game ito, mangyari talaga yung mga ganyan.
Yes.
Expected talaga yan.
Well, the crowd appreciates the effort, no? Kahit na injury siya, the crowd here is appreciating the effort. So sabi ni Christopher Baguio, dili na ma-injured ang goaler ng CMORFA, the best yan. Matik yan, matiba yan. You can see.
May comments agad, ha?
Eh, syempre, proud na proud sila sa kanilang mga... Okay, back to the ball game. CMORFA in control of the ball. Yun.
Post the defense. Yun.
Was kicked out.
Time. So 1-0, one goal for CMORFA.
Ano, kaya tangkay na kanamang kinawa ko, Mr. Live, dikat kami anad. Hindi makayot. Manguna ito, Pi.
goes the attack. Ah, umaatake na naman ngayon si Marofa. Oops, depensa na ng Central Visayas. Ball possession. Yun. May contact. And there's the foul. Yellow card. Substitution now from CMORFA. Doon, may atake. Naiwan, umalik. Central Visayas ang bola. Yun. Yellow. On the way daw si Parker Bell, si
so G. Score is still 1-0 with CMORFA with the lead. 26 and 40 yung running time natin, coach. Yep. And Central Visayas will once again
attack and there
will attack and try to score. But over and over again, the defense of
CMORFA
is there to foil every attempt ng Central Visayas. So just an apologies to our viewers, no, kung medyo nagdalag yung live natin. We have problems with the internet provider. But we are rest assured, we are doing our best para ma-stabilize yung network connection natin dito. Internet connection. Once again, if you've seen another attempt for the Central Visayas, if I'm not mistaken, that's their fourth attempt to score. And over again, yung defense ng CMORFA is there. CMORFA, rather. Okay. An attempt naman for CMORFA, but the goalkeeper is there to save that ball. Central Visayas on the attack. Trying to elude his defender. Passes the ball to number 15. 15 now. Wild kick. As you can see, no, yung defense ng ano, yung defense ng CMORFA.
Clog up agad.
As in, clog every gaps ng
every attempt ng Central Visayas.
Attempts nila. At least 2 to 3 defenders is there. As medyo gumagana yung game plan nila. So with a game like this na defense oriented, of course it's not impossible for Central Visayas to score, but they will really have to earn it the hard way, if ever, na makakagol sila. As you can see, ang bilis ng transition defense ng CMORFA. Always somebody in front. Another player is down for that's the second player for CMORFA. We'll ask some couple of updates. As we can see, yung first player kanina, jersey number 24, is still being attended by our medics. But I think it's okay, yeah. As
He's on his feet and kaya naman. Limping a little bit. But everything's fine.
Water break muna yung both players.
Both teams. Well, grabe yung init dito ngayon, coach, no? Compared to kanina sa first game.
Yeah.
Kanina kasi, sa first game, medyo windy pa. Di pa ganun kainit. But right now,
humid na yung ano yun. Init.
The heat factor is
from the ground.
Sinking in for both teams. Both teams seems to slow down a little bit. But pero syempre, yan yung mga papasok mamaya dyan, yung mga second wing na tinatawag natin. Especially when the crown is on the line. Si Morfa again ngayon. Atake, ball was stolen. Recovered by si Morfa.
Ganda ng defensa talaga ng si Morfa. Ganda ng laro nila.
Yun. They are now on the attack.
On the attack naman sila.
The squad in black now with the ball. Ayan, with an attempt. Will he make that attempt? But the defense of Central Visayas is there.
Good defense niyo yung Central Visayas.
Bumawing Central Visayas sa defense. And they stop the CMORFA not even to attempt. Siyempre, mahirap na pag naging 2-0 to. Sobrang hirap ng habulin yan. With the defense focus CMORFA. Central Visayas once more. Will try to score.
Umatake sila. Yun, defense na naman.
Si Morfa now on the attack. Change of possession. Free ball to. Si Morfa now in control. And the goalkeeper saves the ball easily. Release it to his teammate.
Nakalusot na lang ngayon. Ang ganda ng depensa ng
batak ko naman. Central Visayas
on the attack.
With an attempt. Once again. Sabi ng goalkeeper, not in our house. May pa-gesture pa na pa. Ala ano eh.
Tingnan mo yan.
Not in our house. Not in our goal. It's over and over again, the defense of CMORFA proving. Another player is down, this time for Central Visayas.
Both teams, may mga injury na rin.
Si Morfa now with the possession. And they will try to once again extend their lead. Central Visayas is there. They are now with the possession.
Dumidiskarte yung Central Visayas sa gitna. E medyo maganda pa rin yung depensa ng si Marofa. Ayun. All is out. Running time, coach Joseph. 30.
Running time on this matchup is 1-0 in favor of CMORFA. si Morfa, that's Camiguin-Misamis Oriental Region Football Association. Playing against Central Visayas Football Association. Dito lang yan sa PFF Under 19 Vismin. Live na live dito sa Ciudad de Zamboanga. Dito sa Joaquin Memorial Grandstand.
Joaquin Enriquez Memorial Grandstand.
Siyempre, in attendance dito sa venue are the hundreds, perhaps thousands of football aficionados.
Hindi pa lang masyado kasing na-announce ito, Coach Joseph. Pero kung malaman ito ng mga tao, Sabado ngayon, they think na it's Saturday, walang pasok. Yeah. Office man o sa eskwela. Hindi lang ganito karami yung mga spectators.
So there's a whistle there.
Central Visayas ball.
Central Visayas, no? On the attack. Ball is out.
Ball is out.
Time and time again, the defense of CMORFA is there to foil every attack. Etong CMORFA is really giving a hard time para sa Central Visayas. Bells. CMORFA. Ball is out. .43 and .44. Siyempre, makakasama natin ngayon si partner Belsi Agustin. One of the notable football personalities dito sa Zamboanga. Well, partner Bells, as the game is progressing, nakaunang goal yung CMORFA. As Central Visayas failed to score on their couple of attempts. They've been really aggressive, but the defense of CMORFA, time and time again, foiling every attempts of Central Visayas to score. So, 5 more minutes. Of course, ha, before anything else, introduce ko muna yung magiging kasama namin. At eto guys, ha, I'm sure they will give more wonderful insights when it comes to football as this gentleman here na makakasama natin ngayon. Kumbaga, sa larangan ng football. They have been in the industry since day one. So, partner Bells.
Okay. Maraming salamat, Coach Joseph. Grabe, you just laid a very good foundation para dito sa ating commentators booth in so far as football dito sa R9. It's really, really grateful to have you. Imagine nyo, mga kaibigan, mayong buntag, diha, kung asa man mo ro na mina, nananaw, or kung saan kayo nakikinig ba, syempre manunood kayo. Si Coach Joseph is really a versatile coach. Ang alam na, ang hindi niya lang alam siguro, yung technicalities involved to be a coach of football. But then, practically, it's just basic the way you motivate players, the way you siguro position yung mga players pag naiintindihan niya. But he was able to do it doon sa first, in the first place. Like to congratulate our Samba Sulta Football Association for making it really that far, 5-0. Imagine, never in the history ata, I don't know if Coach Carlo at my back right now, one of the, ito pwede kong sabihin, isa sa mga football pillars ng Sambuanga to, but also hindi lang Sambuanga, because his influence also permeated in the Philippine football arena, because this guy is businessman, he understands football, he still plays right now at the age of, ilang taong ka na, Coach?
27
pa sana, no? Coach,
27 years ago.
Thank you for joining us today. Oo, first off, alam ko wala ka ng bosses, but you were able to join us despite for the love of the game. I want you to give quick insights doon sa nangyari. Well, of course, nakikita natin ngayon is a free kick on the part of sino to? Central Visayas, mostly players coming from Cebu. Bacolod, Iloilo, nako, powerhouse to in so far as football composition is concerned, kasi you know, established ang Cebu, that also matters siguro doon sa mga exposures ng mga bata and the availability of the players where they can choose from, the development from the grassroots, which later on we can know a lot of insights from Coach Carlo. Coach, quick insight doon sa nangyari, doon sa first game kanina, between Sambuanga versus Davao.
Magandang umaga, no? The beautiful game is happening now in Sambuanga. I'd like to thank the Federation, no? Philippine Football, and Samba Sulta for organizing this. And most especially, of course, our beloved Mayor Dalipe, no? Ang pinakamaganda nangyari dito sa atin, ano, is we came from behind, we kept on developing. Nakita ko ang Sambuanga on the first game and the second and then third. I think they're fixed and they completed the game from defending and then eventually completing the whole game in terms of attacking. So it showed in terms of the results, we would have wanted, no, na aabot tayo sa 14 goals. Because that 14 goals now will give us a better chance to qualify, no, para sa to progress to the next division. But 5-0 and a win is a win, no. Napakaganda. The second is, it's not just the results. Nakita natin, ano, napaka organized na, and they started to play the beautiful game, no. Kasi at this age, passing, tactical strategies, the technique is relatively complete. And most importantly, it's all mental ready when you get to here. No?
Coach, I don't know if you will agree. Nakita ko yung kwan, yung attempt ni sino to, Central Visayas, pero mahina. I don't know, back in our time, if you would agree, we never beat Davao. Unless you beat Davao before na hindi ko alam.
Well, it depends on the age.
But so, I don't know, did we make history this morning?
Yes, we made history, no? And with that goal difference, no? 5 goals in any football game is antindi ng results na yan, no?
Yeah. So, medyo one more muna kami, ha? Medyo maingay na dito. It's end of the first half. Right now, championship. versus Camiguin. I don't know why they carry Camiguin. That's supposed to be Cagayan de Oro, but you can opt to carry whatever city you'd like to highlight, diba, Coach? You know, it's really a great privilege to be joined by Coach Carlo kasi ito kasi exposed to dito kami. Exposed kami locally, but we play once in a while. Coach kasi is very, very much exposed in terms of football. Why? Ask me why. Masasagutin ko na. Because anak niya is from Zamboanga, who is Camille Rodriguez, part ng squad ngayon ng World Cup for women's football team. Right, Coach? Siguro, Coach, balikan natin yun. Pag-uusapan natin later on o si Progress. Or perhaps we can talk about it quick lang. Binigay mo na yung insights mo sa nangyari kanina. Even if we beat Davao long time ago for 1-0 or 2-0, but I think we just made a history by beating Davao 5-0. And that's really, really something way, way beyond anyone's expectation. Right, Coach? Not even your expectation. Oo. So in the meantime, kuhan muna kami ha. Quick break. We will try to recuperate dito sa bosses namin habang we're looking forward for another beautiful and exciting second half. But in the meantime, it's 1-0, 1-4 Camiguin, and 0-0 for Central Visayas.